What's up guys, welcome to GPU Price Watch. This is the November installation. I've been doing this series since March of this year to track GPU pricing and try to fight back with the power of friendship and a Google Docs spreadsheet that I've been meticulously updating every month. And the good thing about this series is that it's been positive. Ever since pricing was way too high earlier in the year, things have gotten steadily better every month, and that applies to this month, November as well, which is a good thing because it's Black Friday season. Excellent. Today's video is brought to you by Thermaltake's View600TG Full Tower Chassis, featuring four tempered glass panels that provide an unobstructive view of your PC and support for massive 420mm radiators for AIO or custom cooling. Available in five distinct and unique colorways, including Future Dusk, the View600TG also supports hidden connector and EATX motherboards and includes an anti-sag GPU bracket and rotatable PCIe slots, as well as easily removable ventilation panels and plenty of room for cable management and added storage. There's an optional 6-inch LCD add-on too. For more on the View600TG from Thermaltake, click the sponsor link in the video description. Here's a quick look at the spreadsheet to start us off. These were the numbers for October. And these are the numbers for November. You will note that we have price drops across pretty much all of the Nvidia RTX 50 series GPUs. They've all come down just a little bit, and a lot of that is thanks to the Black Friday sales, with the exception of the RTX 5090. And also, we have at last hit glorious standard base level MSRP for the RX 9070 XT 16GB, which has been one of the most obstinate GPUs, staying priced way too high for too long for most of the year. Before we go into more detail though, a quick note on methodology. I'm using PC Part Picker to look at each individual video card. With the GPU chosen, I'm reality checking the cheapest listings, and I'm collecting the cheapest 10 listings that are in stock and that aren't being sold by some shady reseller on Amazon or Newegg that has very low or mediocre feedback rating, because those can often be scams and definitely a warning to watch out for third-party sellers. It's best to buy directly from the retailers if you can. Also, please note that I'm focusing on GPU prices for this video, but there's definitely other components that you'll need if you're going to build a computer. Memory is one of the ones that has been particularly concerning lately. If you're looking at these trend charts on PC Part Picker, prices have gone way up. Like, oh my gosh, look at that spike. So that is a bit concerning. I will be covering a bit more of the other components in Build Fix this month. Also be doing deal videos towards Black Friday time. And also, since I'm talking about plans for the rest of the year, I do have two more monthly builds, one for this month and one at the beginning of December. Those are gonna be fun videos, and those builds will also be given away to help support our charity live stream, which is gonna be happening on December 6th. We'll be raising money through Extra Life for Children's Miracle Network Hospitals. I'll be doing that with my good friend Kyle, streaming right here from my set area place where I shoot videos. Back to the chart though, just a few notes on this, and then I'll be going over the best current deals at each price tier. And I want to note that for the RTX 40 series graphics cards, these are last gen cards, they're not in production anymore, and none of these are really worth buying. I've only been really tracking these prices for the sake of having the data up there. And even with something like an RTX 4080 8GB dropping in by $30 in price to its $300 MSRP, you should not be buying a 4060 8GB for $300 when you have options like the 5060 8GB for $290, or even better than that, an Arc B580 12GB for $235. That's the lowest price we've seen it yet. Or the RX 9060 XT 8GB for $270, or the 9060 XT 16GB, even better, for $360. But while I often praise AMD Radeon graphics cards for typically offering better bang for the buck versus Nvidia, the Nvidia prices dropping steadily has provided enough competition that it really can be a bit of a toss-up depending on what you're going for. If you really need more VRAM, then going with one of the 16GB option is definitely going to be something worth considering, and the 9060 XT 16GB, even for slightly more than its MSRP at $360, is the cheapest way to do that. Of course, you have the 5060 Ti 16GB for just a bit more. That's down to $400 this month, so that makes it a bit more of a tough decision. The good news, of course, is that you have reasonably priced options either way. The cards from Nvidia that I would typically avoid would be the 5050 8GB. It is just a very underpowered card, and there's better options like the B580 12GB or even the 9060 XT 8GB at that price, so don't go for that one. And then the second bit of general advice, especially if you're looking to game at a high resolution like 1440 or get higher frame rates like you might need at 1440 or higher refresh rate 1080, I would say try to get a card with more than 8GB of VRAM. There is sort of a floor for the 8GB cards. You need to spend a little bit more money to get yourself up to a 16GB option, or of course the Arc B580 option at $235 is a great starting point for anyone who's building a new gaming PC right now. So that's the higher level overview of the market right now. Next, I'm gonna go through the different pricing tiers and say what my recommendation would be for each one, starting with the $200 to $300 price tier. And my number one recommendation here is gonna be that Arc B580, which has 12 gigs of VRAM, and it's down to the lowest price that we've seen it. It's available through B&H for $235 right now. This one was selling for $300-ish, which is $50 over its MSRP. The MSRP is $250. So this one falls into the category of not the most screaming deal I've ever seen, but if you're on a budget and you want more VRAM and you don't wanna pay the Nvidia tax for like a very underpowered 5050 8 gig or 5060 8 gig, then that would totally be the way to go. The alternative option here is gonna be the RX 9060 XT, but AMD is making this one harder and harder to recommend. It has been available for as low as $250, $50 off its MSRP, but that price has crept back up somewhat and now it's available for about $270. When I was collecting all the data, it was available for $260, but it looks like that one has gone out of stock. This one just feels a little bit better at $250. This $260 option is open box, so keep an eye out for those if you are shopping directly on sites like Newegg. And I have been reality checking prices today because a lot of Black Friday sales have just kicked in, which is offering us the lowest price ever on some Nvidia options, such as the GeForce RTX 5060 8GB. Not always one that we would highly recommend, but for $310 minus a $20 off promo code, that brings it down to $290. So that would be my number three choice in this price category, although it is a closer number three choice this month because of the 9060 XT's 8GB not having that great a price. Moving up to the $300 to $400 price tier, here you should definitely not be settling for an 8GB graphics card. There are 16GB options in this range. And the number one choice for me, even though the price has climbed up a little bit, is the $360-ish RX 9060 XT 16GB. This card isn't too much up from its lowest price that we've seen, which was $350. You do get a 16GB VRAM buffer and a nice step up in rasterization performance versus a card like a B580 or an RTX 5060 or 5060 Ti. That said, the 5060 Ti 8GB is also at its lowest price ever. Again, I wouldn't recommend this card unless you just absolutely know you're not going to be playing any games that go beyond an 8GB VRAM buffer. For buying a new graphics card in 2025, I still would feel hesitant to go for an 8GB VRAM option, but I do want to point out that this card has come down a little bit. And like all of these RTX 50 series cards in the mid-tier, minus the 5090, they're all a little bit below the MSRP. What's also cool is in my discussion of the $300 to $400 price tier in months past, I've said we have sort of a not official entry here, which is the 5060 Ti 16GB, which is typically sold for $420, $430 at the cheapest. That's now down to $400. This is via a Newegg Black Friday promotion. It does include a $20 rebate card, so that may or may not apply to you. So this does make it a bit more of a difficult choice versus the 9060 XT 16GB. So this is definitely a card I would consider as well in this price category. The next price tier would be $400 to $500, which I've typically skipped also in months past because there's been no official card that lands within that price range that is compelling. However, we now have a $400 to $500 price tier thanks to the 5070, coming down $60 versus last month at minus 70 versus its $550 MSRP. This is also an MSI Ventus model available via Newegg with their Black Friday deals. And again, this one counts a $20 mail-in rebate card, but it has a base price of $500, which is $50 below MSRP, bringing that down to $480, is also the cheapest 5070 that we've seen all year. That gives you a 12GB VRAM buffer. It would be nice to get 16GB for this price, but you also get a pretty significant boost in raw rasterization performance versus the 5060 Ti. From there, we move to the $500 to $600 price tier, and here the RX 9070, since it came down to its MSRP of $550, has been my go-to choice. However, for about $70 less, I would say the RTX 5070 is very much a contender here, unless you really need that extra 4GB of VRAM since you have 16GB with the RX 9070 non-XT, then the 5070 is a very compelling choice. However, the other standout for this month compared to previous months is that the RX 9070 XT, which also has a nice boost up in raw rasterization performance versus the non-XT version, is finally down to its MSRP. And we've had several celebrations of cards being available for MSRP over the course of this series. And every time I've tried to say, now this isn't a fantastic price, this isn't an amazing deal, we're only happy because it sold for so much above MSRP for so long. Rounding out the $500 to $600 price category, we have an honorable mention of the 7900 XT 20GB. This is a last gen card. It's part of the RX 7000 series. However, it is $310 down from its MSRP, selling for almost the cheapest we've seen it. It was $580 last month. Now it's $590, or I guess technically $591 if we're rounding properly. But this card, again, I would only recommend if you're doing something that really needs 20 gigs of VRAM, which could apply to you if you're doing a lot of AI work or something else that requires more heavy lifting and that benefits from additional VRAM. Likewise, there is the RX 7900 XTX, which has 24 gigs of VRAM. This also is not the cheapest price that we've seen this card for. It's been down to $750. But again, if you need a 24 gig VRAM card and you don't want to spend upwards of $1,000, actually upwards of probably $2,000 or more if you're considering something like a 4090 or a 5090, this is definitely the best bang for your buck in terms of VRAM capacity, with the possible exception of that 7900 XT for $590. All right, our final three price tiers are a little bit more boring because there's basically only one card in each tier, but we have good news for all of those except for the 5090. For the $700 to $800 price tier, there's the RTX 5060 Ti 16GB, and here we again have a low price down to $730 if you count the mail-in rebate card. And here, I guess, again, not a fantastic price, but given that there's not really much competition around here, it's good to see the prices going down rather than coming up. Likewise, if you move up to the next step, that's about $1,000 for the RTX 5080 16GB. And again, not a lot of excitement here, but there is at least a 5080 available for less than $1,000, $989. It's available at Walmart. You know, Walmart, always known for their GPU deals. And then our final entry, if you're going for the best GPU you can buy in terms of performance, is the 5090, but here's where we have the most disappointment. Over the past 2 to 3 months, the 5090 has been available somewhat regularly for its $2,000 MSRP, which is not a great deal or anything, but for people who are looking for the best of the best, at least it's not $2,500 or up. But now, and it's hard to say whether this is due to inventory availability or the amount of 5090 dies that Nvidia is producing, but prices have jumped pretty significantly by about $700 to $800 for the cheapest models I was able to find. So if you're really in the market for a 5090, my recommendation is to be patient, sign up for price alerts, keep an eye on Best Buy because they sometimes bring in Founders Edition models. Try to hold out for that $2,000 MSRP if you can, because if you're spending $2,500 or more, you're telling the retailers and the manufacturers that you're okay spending that much money for a 32 gig graphics card. And also a warning again that cheaper models are often coming from shadier resellers. There's supposed to be a $2,400 version here, but even this one for $2,789 is coming from a retailer with 19 ratings in the past year and a 79% positive. That's pretty borderline for me. I really feel like as a third-party reseller, you should be able to maintain at least above 90% if you're not doing any shadiness with your sales or anything. Oh look, 10% restocking fee when prod cut, outside box damaged or condition poor. Great, good to know. I also do not envy PC part pickers' job of trying to keep all these pricing listings up to date with the amount of shady third-party sellers who go and try to sell stuff that seems like a good deal until you try to order it and then they don't ship it or they ship you something else. Third-party marketplace sellers are not always the most trustworthy or reliable place to buy GPUs, especially if you're buying something that's upward of $1,000. But that's all the time we have for GPU Price Watch for November 2025. I will post links to the recommended GPUs down in the video description. Also down there, you can find a link to my store at pulsehardware.net where you can buy shirts, mugs, and pint glasses to help support the channel. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe if you'd like to be notified of my upcoming videos. Maybe hit the thumbs up button on your way out if you enjoyed this one. We'll see you all in the next video.